56 skiers lined up for the start of the women's giant slalom and the alloc course at Pozza di Fassa. Only one of them, the Slovakian Jana Gantnarova, who took silver in the downhill, had made it onto the podium, so plenty of incentive for the field in what was likely to be an open event. One of the staples of the Universiade, it was a West German, Barbie Henneberger, who won the inaugural event in Switzerland back in 1962, when these girls weren't even a glint in their father's schoolboy eyes. Last time it was an American, Jenny Van Wagner, who took gold. Italy looking for a repeat of Camille Alfieri's victory, the last time the Universiade was held on home snow in 2007. It was the Americans who won this event last time out, and the influence of their current skiing superstar Lindsey Vonn running deep in the young skiers brought Wales the third fastest, 0.55 seconds behind the leader. Austria have a reputation for being quick, although this isn't their best event. University of Hagen student Michelle Morik, though, eager to make her mark on these games. She was second quickest on the first run, marginally quicker than Wales, but still half a second behind the leader. And that leader was, as you can see, Maryna Gasienica-Daniel from the Jerzy Kukuska Academy of Physical Education in Krakow. The 19-year-old had to settle for 12th in the Super G earlier in the week. This time she intended to set the pace and pick up a medal. Her first run time of 55.09, giving her half a second advantage on the rest of the field. Well, now into the second run, and Veronica Smedh was sitting fifth after the first run with a time of 55.77 seconds. But the 25-year-old Swede quickly began to make up for that. Suzanne Ekman was the last Swede to win a medal in this event. That was in 1999 in Slovakia. Smedh, though, who is a student at Mid-Sweden University in Östersund, really got the bit between her teeth going a little bit wide on that angle. Otherwise, she worked the angle superbly, flying down the mountain and coming home in a time of 1:51.54, an overall time. That put her into provisional top spot. Wales had been 0.13 seconds quicker than Smedh in the opening run, but the American faltered at the second time of asking. Overall time 1:53.42, seeing her slip to 18th overall. Morik's task was pretty straightforward. Hold what you have at the end of the first run and try to post a time that was quick enough to put a little bit of pressure on Gasienica. And she was looking for Austria's first medal in the event since Dietlind Kloss in 1970, a remarkably poor record for such a ski-friendly nation. It was a solid run from Morik, but perhaps a little bit too conservative, slower than her first run. An overall time of 1:51.23, good enough to push Smedh down into second, but probably not strong enough to pressure Gasienica into making a mistake. The last Pole to win this event was Dagmara Krishnisk. She took gold in 2001 and 2005, going on to compete in the 2006 Winter Olympics in Turin. Gasienica, not surprisingly, keen to follow that example. She was almost half a second faster than the rest of the field on the first run. And while the others played a touch conservatively on the second run, she was able to ski within herself. No problems at all coming down the mountain. Nice, smooth, easy run. An overall time of 1:50.99 seconds. She finished 0.24 seconds ahead of Morik. Gold medal for Gasienica. So there we have it, Gasienica Daniel taking the gold medal, Michelle Morik with the silver, and the third place going to Smedh of Sweden. Poland's third medal of these games in the alpine skiing, but their first gold medal. Karolina Krapak won silver in the Super G and bronze in the downhill. A good day also for the Austrians and the Swedes.